the reign of God has come near, and by authority of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are God's beloved. Amen.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated. We'll continue with our scripture readings. The first word we come to is Psalm 139. It is a response as well. I invite you to lift your voices. Lord, you have searched me out. O Lord, you have known me. You trace my journeys and my resting places and are acquainted in all my ways.
Indeed, there is not a word on my lips, but you, O Lord, know it all together.
You encompass me behind and before and lay your hand upon me.
Such a knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain to it.
For you yourself created my innermost parts and knit me together in my mother's womb.
I will thank you because my promise is made. Your works are wonderful, and I know it well.
My body was not hidden from you while I was being made in secret and woven in the depths of the earth.
Your eyes did not know my limbs, yet I finished in the womb. All of them were written in your book.
How deep I find your thoughts, O God. How great is the sum of them. Get together and like do something. in the family, especially when we talk about the family of God. All of you are important. Oh, you love your little brother, right? Well, they're spreading out. Maybe we'll have some more conversations about than that. But the most important thing, right? Each one of you, each one of us is a child of God. Thank you. greater things than these. And he said to him, very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. This is the gospel of our Lord. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. Nathaniel and his experience maybe has heard a narrative. have that here. North Minneapolis, South Minneapolis, Twin Cities. You know, Minnesota was just ranked, what, third safest place to live? For who? For who? If Nathaniel is to believe, to trust, he wants to know Jesus is the real, authentic Messiah, the Son of God, and in their interaction, Jesus is. Jesus is the Son of God and reveals enough truth in their conversation. The things that only Nathaniel and Philip would have known to affirm that it's truth. Jesus then holds Nathaniel's attention, inquiring now his faith, trust, belief. Just because you heard something, now you changed your tune. How come not before? I wonder if this is an encouragement in its complexity to keeping true to who Nathaniel is as well. Things that he is practicing. Could he be practicing? That's another wondering as we look at Scripture, right? There are many possibilities for how the Spirit might move and guide us. And so, have we ever wondered about Nathaniel's story? Who he is, where he came from? Why is he sitting? Why does he even say deceit? There's a story. And I wonder in his discernment, he just wants to wait and see what's because maybe Nathaniel himself has been hurt. Hurt by those he was supposed to be trusted in. Those who were in his community. At some point in our lives, we're looking at where we are going. Imagining the future and what's possible. Seeking to see the good for the whole collective of humanity and creation. Tough. It's tough, like Nathaniel's story. He doesn't want to be deceived one more time. That's how the scripture lands with me when I hear Nathaniel speaking. I don't want to be deceived one more time. Is this the real thing? Am I going to get hurt if I follow? What made him pause? What makes him unlike Philip, where following Jesus might be a path to where there's pain and there's struggle and work? Because maybe Nathaniel has had broken trust, relationships, feeling of loneliness among his fellow humans. Stories like Nathaniel. might not have been able to get to see this spot happening. We're here. As we wrestle with ourselves, with our God who is on the move, we hear that in the language that our ancestors carried on to stir them and move them, that God is on the move. That God is always and will forever be marching on forward in guiding us along. As our ancestors before us, Nathaniel and Philip and Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King and all the cloud of witnesses found it to be true. That we are here and we are standing before those powers. Those powers of sin and death and evil, and we are here to denounce them and say, today is not that day. Follow me, Jesus says. I am that path, I am the light of the world, and I got you, and we are walking on this path together. We have opportunities to follow God, who is already moving. God is good, as we say, how often?
All the time.
All the time. And all the time that God is good. Yes. As I said last week, we get to be lights in the world. As Dr. King said, a shining moment in the conscience of humanity. There never is a moment more honorable and inspiring than the pilgrimage of people of every race and every faith pouring into the face of danger at the side of embattlement. We are here for each other because we know that there is no life if one of us is not having life. Right? We all are in this together and on the way together. Once again, we are seeing a peacetime that is shifting. I don't know if you have noticed the ongoing, both locally and nationally and globally, but this time that we have called for generations that has been named as a peacetime is being threatened, is being dismantled, is being torn apart. And when we hear Jesus calling us to follow, we'll follow. When the burning and the bombing and the beating and the harming of God's children is happening, will we answer that call to be there for one another, to answer God's call, follow me? Faith is, and I'm glad that we talked about basketball earlier, because faith is a team sport. Faith is a team sport. It's a Wii sport, not to be confused with Wii, the Nintendo game system that you play, right? There is a game of Wii sport, right? But we, collectively, in our commonality as humans, as creation, we are in this together. In this community, we choose curiosity. We choose that over certainty. We strive to honor each other's own faith expressions and life experiences with respect and love. We're called to think and to speak and to act with love-centered thinking and speaking. That was a core tenet. If you didn't see my little note from your pastor this week, go click on that link. Explore that legacy, that that we push one another to do better, to be better. We have potential to do that. That we draw each other in. That this darkest of days, whether they be our yesterdays or our today, tomorrow outshines that. Tomorrow outshines that. Because tomorrow and the day after that, and keep looking forward, are the brightest yet to come. Do better day by day. The road over the centuries with Philip and with Nathaniel, with Jesus, with Dr. King, and others, those roads all together are not smooth ones by any means. So what are we doing? What are we doing? So I invite us to remember this day and always that we have a freedom worth fighting for, a reason to sing a song like Mary. Mary sang because she saw the brightest of tomorrows. We have freedom worth dying for. We must keep going. We must keep going now and always. So I invite you, put a cross on your forehead or your hand, whatever you feel comfortable with. Say that I am beloved. I am loved. Amen. Continuing our response to what God is doing. We receive our tithes and our offerings. We sit in God's generosity and say thank you. Thank you for all that you do and who you are and the gifts that you give, the times and the talents and the treasures. Thank you. We also invite you to sing. There are two songs that you'll find in your printed bulletin. Let us respond. in you we are called to find our unity. Come into the brokenness of our lives and our land with your healing love. Help us to be willing to bow before you in true repentance and to bow to one another in real forgiveness. By the fire of your Holy Spirit, melt our hard hearts and consume the prejudice and the pride which separates us. Fill us, O Lord, with your perfect love that casts out fear and binds us together in unity. That you share with our Creator and the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Hear our prayer. For the nations, we pray. Mighty and loving God, we pray for our nation and the plague of racism that threatens to destroy and kill. Root out supremacy wherever it takes hold. Release its grip on those lured by its false promises. Bring to repentance all who continue to benefit from the prejudice and hatred, both hidden and revealed. Plant in our hearts and nation a willing spirit to open to truth-telling and healing. Lord, have mercy. Hear our prayer. For those who are oppressed and victimized, we pray. Emmanuel, God with us, you embrace and love those who cry out to you. Lift up all whom hatred has cast down. Embolden those who need courage to speak and act against oppression, sustain those who are weary from efforts that bring no end to injustice. Comfort parents weeping for children, children who have been separated or senselessly killed. We hold parents and families during crisis of any kind. Restore hope where it has been lost, so that all may trust your love that reaches to the depths of pain and suffering, that reaches out and says, follow me, for I am here with you. Lord, have mercy. Hear our prayer. Lord God, when we are assaulted by the troubles of life, and the deep waters of anger threaten to overwhelm us, do not let us sink. In your great compassion, hear us and help us. Deliver us from anger's power over us. Lead us out of bitter silence and hurtful words, so that we may speak truth in love. Heal every heart. Show us the way to kindness and honesty and reconciliation. For the one who has shown us both in passion, zeal, and Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those that rest on our hearts and minds this day, as we have many in our own community that are in need of your prayer and your healing, O God. We lift up and pray for Levine in her continuing recovery and strength. We pray for Doris, Andrea, Peyton, and Lola, and Ruby, and Paul, Patricia, Sarah, Claudia. We pray for Roger and Sharon as they recover from COVID. We pray for Mary, Paul, and her recovery. We pray for the Hanson family. As I have Owen Hansen passed away this last week, we pray for Mark and for Aaron and Melissa, Elizabeth, Ezra, Isaac.
Right. Well, there is lots of good sharing of the peace, but I invite you to
show up for this community, for worship and study and prayer and service to others. Will you practice being curious about Scripture, your neighbor, and God's ongoing creation in daily life? Will you share your sense of call and unique gifts with the spirit of generosity in the life of the congregation? If so, say, we will, and we ask God to help and guide us. sing our dismissal as your